is 20020. This is also called electrodynamometer. So here this is the bar meter, this is the needle here, this is the scale, there are 0 to 16,000 range. This is here we can see there is a screw, this is a zero adjusting screw. This is used for setting the zero position of the pointer. If the pointer is not at the zero, with the help of this screw we can set that position. Now here these two are the voltage terminal, these two, this one and this one, and the middle terminal is common. Now the current terminal is this one, this LA, marked as LA. These four terminals are current terminals. And these terminals marked as E1, E2 here and here, these terminals are the changeover terminal. The connection of three-phase wattmeter with the three-phase power supply and the load, we have made the connection exactly like this shown in here. So here we can see this is the variac, three-phase variac. So from the output we have connected it, the R, this is R, R is connected with M. After that this is the B, B is connected with M here, and this is Y, Y is connected with the common. These are the loads. So here this one load is connected with L, and this one here is connected with L here, and this one, this load, the third load is the connect, is connected with common. So like this, connect your wattmeter with the power supply and the load, and after that turn on the load and you can see the deflection in the wattmeter. Now to see the deflection in the wattmeter, you need to connect a load which whose power factor must be zero, otherwise there will be no deflection. Here as we have used bulb here, so there will be no deflection in the wattmeter when we turn on the load. On the wattmeter, please connect a load whose power factor is zero. This is portable analog AC voltmeter. Order code is 20027. So this is the voltmeter, this is the needle. With the help of this screw we can adjust the position of the needle, and this is the scale. There are three range, 125, 250 and 500. So this is the common terminal, this is the terminal for 125, this is the terminal for 250 and this is the terminal for 500. Now we have connect the voltmeter to the source and the load. So we have used this connection here for voltmeter. So connect the phase here at the terminal at whichever range you have selected. I have selected 125 range, so I have connected it with this terminal, and connect the neutral with common. Now connect the load, this is like this, with positive terminal to phase and negative terminal to common. Now turn on the power supply. We can see as we are giving voltage, the bulb is on and this is the voltage showing in the voltmeter. This analog portable power meter, it is also called electrodynamometer. So this is the power meter here, this is the scale, this is the needle, these are the voltage terminal, this is the current terminal, this is common, and this is the changeover terminal, this E1 and E2. Now we have connected the power factor meter with a power supply and a load to see the power factor. We have used this connection here. So first from line we have connected this M terminal, and from this M terminal we have connected common, and we have connected the neutral terminal to voltage terminal. After that we have connected the load to L and to this voltage terminal, exactly like in this picture. Now give the load and we can see the deflection on the power factor meter as we are increasing the load.